Hey, Eckert here. I'm back for part two. Intermission just occurred for our suicide lesson. I went and took a walk because that's what the missus and I have been doing every day during quarantine to try and move around and stay active as much as we can. So I had a little break. It's good for the mind, the body, and let's get right back into our lesson. So the next part of the lesson, hopefully you've filled out the article, read the article on 13 Reasons Why, and you filled out your thoughts and the ramifications of the series. Sum that up. Hopefully you did so in at least minimum three sentences. Next part. There will always be, when you click on something like this, and we have a link set to it, the link's going to pop up down below here. Now, this says complete all five by World Suicide Prevention Day, which is in September. It's not required, but I do want you, we do want you to go through and at least brief yourself on each of these five areas. So when you go to this website, this is... Their catchphrase, if you will, is take five to save lives. So there's five steps to taking action to help someone or learn and identify the signs of suicide, the warning signs, and then find out how to help and, you know, take care of yourself. So I'm going to click through these, and when we click on learn more, it's not each individual one. They give you all five on this next page. And at minimum, I want you to go through and I want you to read the five blurbs on taking five steps to save lives. So what's the first step? Learn the signs. It's not always obvious, but there are signs that people will display or exhibit, and you can sort of look out for, and when you know what these things are, and all of a sudden you see them because you've learned what those warning signs are, there's that memory that sort of triggers a response. You're like, whoa, I know what I'm seeing here, right? So what are those? So when you go into each one of these, you can complete the step. And this is something we're going to provide for bonus points. If you complete each one of these steps, there is a form that you can fill out. You put your email in, and it helps them tally a total to sort of reach their mission for the year, right? So it goes through each one of these steps and it tells you more in detail about the steps. So emergency warning signs, it tells you to really call 911 or emergency service number if someone's starting to hurt or kill themselves or talking of wanting to die. Someone looking for ways to kill themselves. This is the serious things, right? This is an emergency. You need to call 911, the authorities. And then there's the warning signs. Something that, it's not an emergency situation, but you should probably try and either, if it, you're going through this yourself or you know someone that are displaying these signs, seek help. And that's things like hopelessness, uncontrolled anger, rage, involving themselves in risky behaviors. If someone feels trapped, like there's no way out, any increase in alcohol, drug use, agitated, anxious behaviors, withdrawing from family and friends is a big one and a very common warning sign, and then mood swings. And then they provide you with some helpline information, places you can go to get help. Once you read through these, and become acquainted with this stuff, you click on the completed button. a thing pops up, says, great job. You can put your name and email address and they can count you towards people participating in this. You don't have to submit that. It's not going to spam you. I've done it. I've gotten no spam at all. But what you can do is you can take a picture or a screen capture of this image and you can upload it and send it to us via Classroom, and we will give you extra credit in the gradebook if you complete these. So there's five of them. I did the first one. The second one talks about how to help people or how to help yourself. And then practicing self-care, just like anything in your life, if you exercise, if you're proactive about things, then you can prevent ever getting to a sort of like a bad place, right? You exercise, you eat healthy, you're never going to become, you know, unhealthy physically or obese because you're practicing good habits. The same thing can be said for your psychological and your brain. Is if you take care of yourself mentally, you're not going to have as serious of issues as other people that don't do that, right? Reach out is step four, and that's looking for resources, places that can help you or other people that are struggling, and then spread the word. We hear that advocate piece that we always talk about at East High as part of our mission and vision as a school, advocating for self and others. That's spreading the word, you know, sharing information about this stuff, bringing awareness. That's you spreading the word. That's you advocating for yourself and others. And then again, there's our suicide helpline. And let's go back to the learning tracker. So once you've acquainted yourself with those, we have an article for you to read on teen suicide. I'll click on that and I'll show you the article. And this is a Teens Health article. And the thing I really like about this is this section here, and I'm not going to spoil it because I really want you to read this for yourselves, is why do teens try and kill themselves? So this really dives down deep into why teens specifically try to hurt themselves or have these thoughts. It talks about substance abuse, depression, how some suicide cannot always be planned, but these risky behaviors can lead to suicide. I can think of recent, unfortunately, former students. One in particular comes to mind that committed suicide, but it was accidental. He did not intend to, but when you're careless with your life and you don't value these things, sometimes you can make mistakes and take your own life. So then we have warning signs, and this section here talks about if this is you, what you can do, and if it's someone you know, what you can do for that person, right? So I want you to go through this article and fill out the graphic organizer down below. So there's all these sections that we want you to complete about suicidal ideation. Eckert, what is ideation? Oh, it's a vocab word. Scroll up. Ideation, thinking about it. Formation of ideas or concepts, right? So suicidal ideation is it forming these ideas about it in your brain or someone else's brain, right? So why does it happen? What is it? In these boxes, we want you to put risk factors, the signs, how to help someone, how to practice self-care. Ooh, this is similar to this, the take five up here. And you're also going to read a lot about this in the article. And then finally is your exit ticket. And the exit ticket gives you a scenario. And it is, it's authentic and it could happen. And it could be something that you might have seen or you could see someday. And hopefully, you know, talking about these things, you can be equipped with the tools to help people. And that's what health's all about, right? So I'm going to read this scenario to you, and then I want you to respond. So your friend has been depressed for a couple months. You really miss them lately. The two of you spend every weekend together, shooting hoops, playing video games, watching TikTok. Funny. Now you never hang out. You never get to catch up at lunch anymore either because they haven't been in school in a week. You're starting to get worried, so you call them. They make a promise to come to school tomorrow. When they make it to school, it was just like old times. They were so happy and asked if you wanted to hang out this weekend. Then they thank you for being such an amazing friend and not giving up on them. They gave you their copy of your favorite book. When you were sitting together at lunch, your friends shared that their parents have been fighting a lot, and their mom is really mad at them because you got caught stealing at Walmart. The cops got called, but they didn't get arrested this time, but they do have to go to court. You're going to have to go hang out at their house because they are not allowed to go anywhere until everything is settled at court. So with that situation, that scenario, you're concerned that your friend may be thinking about suicide. What evidence supports that thinking? What clues do you see in that scenario that that person may be thinking about hurting themselves? And what would your next step be, or your next steps be, as a friend, someone that cares about them, to help them? You're going to respond below. And notice there's lots of space for you, meaning your response should be decent in length, right? And then finally, that's all the physical work you have to do. But we, Miss Larry and I, we wanted to put links to all your counselors' emails. So if you're struggling, especially during this time of isolation, and I know that when I've Zoomed office hours, I haven't had a lot of kids, but usually the kids that hop on are kids that just want to not really talk about work, but they just want to see how I'm doing, tell me about what's going on with them, and I understand that completely. And if you want to use office hours, my office hours, to do that, I support that. Or if, you know, there's more than one person in the office hours, and you do want to talk more on a one-on-one basis with me, email me. I'll set up a separate time with you, and we can talk one-on-one if that's something you want to do. I am here for you. Mrs. Flaherty's here for you, and we want you to know that we are here to support you, even though we can't physically do so. And if you reach out, then we will do everything that we can to help you through this. Because it's not over yet, and we really don't know when this thing's gonna end, and this might be an interesting summer. So links to all the counselors. As always, we provide you a criteria for success after the exit ticket. So whenever you complete an exit ticket, remember, we've always given you clues and tools to help you do the work. So these are the components that you need to have in your response. No one wants a one, no one wants a two. You want to be in the 3-4 range. So make sure in your response you're identifying 4 more warning signs of suicide from the story. Make sure that you're providing advice for your friend, at least asking, listening, believing them, and to not promise to keep it a secret. And you need to be able to identify specific name of a person in school, out of school, and the suicide hotline. So I just thought of the video I was thinking of earlier that I stupidly couldn't remember. It's by the artist Logic, and it's the name of the song is the actual like suicide prevention hotline. So I'll share my screen again, and then we can have this play us out. And this is a really nice song in that it starts out all like doomy and gloomy, and but there's like a light at the end of the tunnel. And I know that this song in particular, the individual, if you watch the actual video of it, it's about an individual that's struggling with their sexual identity. And these are things that individuals your age deal with in a ever-developing brain. And things are tough now, or can be tough now, but understand that things get much easier, and you get much more perspective when you get out of high school and you complete and you graduate, and you look back on it, and you can see how much you've grown. So I'll let this place out. I hope you guys have a great week, and stay healthy, stay active. And again, if you guys need anything, you could reach out to your counselors or myself or Mrs. Flaherty. And yeah, we'll talk to you soon.
I wanna feel alive, I don't even wanna die.